Hello, everyone. Welcome to GoTaren TV. I'm Taren, the traveling trainer with GoTaren Personal Training. Here in the greater Atlanta area, about to welcome back an awesome guest right back here on today's show, Mr. Nathan Nowak of Trinity Body. Now, before Nathan returns back here on today's show, I'd like to ask everyone out there, if you'd please be so kind as to like this video, leave us a comment, and share it with all of your friends and family out there. I have invited Nathan to come back on today's show. We're going to check in. It's been a few months. Going to see how his world is going. As I understand, a lot has changed with not only his business, but also his business model. How's everything going with him and Stephanie? And just everything else that's going on as it's been influenced by this pandemic that we've been going through. So it's going to be really interesting. I love talking to this guy. 30 minutes flies by so quickly with him. So we're going to jam-pack as much information as we can. I'll do a little Q&A with him and see how everything's going with Trinity Body and how Nathan Nowak is adjusting to this whole pandemic that we're going through. So it's going to be really interesting. I'm looking forward to today's show. And we'll have him join us here momentarily. And remember, with GoTaren Personal Training, it's your time, it's your investment, it's your life. We'll be back in a Okay, welcome back, everyone. As I promised, side by side, once again, we are rejoined here on GoTaren TV with Nathan Nowak. Nathan, how are you doing out there today?
I'm good. How are you?
Very good, thanks. And, you know, it's been a couple of months since we got to chat.
Yeah,
here we are, and, you know, this year's flying by. We're in the spring, and 1 year removed from the beginning of this crazy pandemic looking back. So my first question to you, Nathan, as we kind of check in and see how everything's going, how is business, and if it is a little bit different than when I last talked to you, how is the adjustment with like a 1 year retrospect when you look back on how it's affected your business and everything going on?
Yeah, well, it's completely different now. We're completely online.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. I mean, I see some people, but that's not part of our business. Our business is completely, everything's online now.
Interesting. Okay.
Yeah. And you know, it's, I think when I first met you a couple of years ago, we had a lot of stuff. I closed my gym and we were doing, you know, starting to do stuff online, but I think the pandemic has pushed us to just say, you know what, go ahead and do it. And it's probably one of the best things that could have happened.
Wow, you know, good.
Unfortunately for, you know, people are getting sick and that's unfortunate. But yeah. I think a lot of businesses, not just in fitness and nutrition, but I think a lot of businesses have realized my employees can stay home. I don't need a huge building. I don't need lights. I don't need the overhead. We can do everything from our pajamas. And I would hope that a lot of people that don't need that brick and mortar don't go back, because you're going to see that you don't need all the overhead expense in order to still do what you're doing. And I think the businesses that were able to make that jump to online have survived. I mean, it's a little bit different. Strategies are different, but I mean, business is business and people still need stuff. Mm-hmm. So it's worked out really well for us. And we're building, I think the thing that has been the most challenge for me is social media. We're on social media all the time, and that's how we get most of our clients. You know, we have our Facebook groups. Okay. We do a lot of lives, a lot of YouTube, a lot of Instagram, and it's constantly just being in front of people and then moving them over to our groups and then, you know, showing them our products and services and getting them signed up for stuff. So that's probably because you and I, you know, we didn't have all of that back in the day. You know, we just had to get out and hustle. I do miss having seminars. I do miss the in-person interaction with people. Mm-hmm. And I think we're getting back to that. Mm-hmm. But for the most part, unless we're not doing like 3-day events or something, I think we're going to stay online and just keep it, you know, keep it how it is.
Interesting. That's great. I'm glad to hear that, Nathan. That's terrific. Y'all were able to make such a positive out of such a negative and turn this into your favor.
Yeah.
And how about, let me ask you this, with it now being online, is that an opportunity then, I assume, to train more people because you've got a greater reach to be able to reach not only here in Atlanta, but obviously elsewhere outside of the state?
Yes, and the way I've set up our programs is we have different tiers. So somebody can come in we have one product that's $21 for 21 days, mm-hmm. and it's just the baseline product. It's, you know, do it yourself.
Okay.
You read the manual, you follow the program, you do it. Then we have another tier up where they'll get, you know, webinars. They'll get, we used to do our supermarket tour in person. We do it as a webinar now. So you'll go through the supermarket, but it's on a webinar. Huh. You know, and then we've got, there's some other bonuses and stuff with that, some coaching. And then the highest tier would be a lot of personal interaction with me and Stephanie. But a lot of our programs, you know, if you see it on online, we could be sleeping at 2 a.m. Someone clicks on it. They could go to it. They could sign up and they can get started. We don't have to be open. We don't, you know, it can be a Sunday night. We don't have to be working. A lot of this stuff is just automated so that we, like you said, anyone, anywhere can sign up for it at any time. So our reach is a lot bigger than just where we are, you know, located, or if I go speak or something like that.
Oh, that's so cool. You know, that's great. And you mentioned a couple minutes ago about maybe sometime in the near future, possibly returning back to doing in-person things. Do you see that happening foreseeably this year, to be able to get together and meet some of your clients in person and do some in-person stuff once this pandemic kind of goes away?
I think for like fitness and nutrition, and I think for everybody, I think that everything's starting to open up. And you know, on one side, you hear all these COVID numbers are still going up, but then on the other side, you still hear that people are going to start going out and we're starting to open everything. So I don't really understand, because the COVID numbers, if they are going up, then why are we opening up? But you know, I don't know, whatever that is. Mm-hmm. But I think that for the people that do want to go back and be interactive with people, I think that that is going to, it's going to be a definite. Steph and I, our interaction with people will be on our lives, our seminars, mm-hmm. and our workshops. But you know, for the most part, you know, everything is going to stay online. Mm-hmm. You know, we don't have to worry about a gym. We don't have to travel in traffic. We don't have to worry about anything. We can work. This is our office. Hmm. You know, we work here. You know, we put in regular days just like everybody else, but we're able to communicate and do more, you know, without having to really be in front of people and spend that time in traffic and that kind of stuff. So I think some gyms are going to open. A lot of gyms closed. I mean, you know that.
Yeah.
Lot of gyms, a lot of businesses in general just closed because they just couldn't keep up, mm-hmm. You know, and they just didn't know how to make that jump to online. Mm-hmm. But the ones that did, the ones that had email lists, the ones that were able to communicate with their customers and then offer them something else, those are the ones that they're staying around. Those are the ones that adapted and are able to overcome this, you know, this last year.
Yeah. You know, yeah. You're right. Depending on some of the sources I read were that actually some of the gyms that were the hardest hit were the big commercial busy gyms like LA Fitness, Lifetime Fitness. I heard they took the biggest hit because of the whole paranoia, right, of, you know, they're let's face it, they've got the biggest overhead, so they've got the hugest expense to do. And so, yep. With lack of membership, that's their, you know, heart and soul. So they were actually proportionally probably hit more in the pocketbook than any of the other places, which is interesting. You mentioned too, Nathan, a few minutes ago about the, and again, that's true. You can do so much more now because you can leverage your time better because you're not sitting in traffic. And on the flip side, your clients as well, it's beneficial for them because they're not having to drive and meet you wherever, you know, you're working out at, and they can just do it from home too. So with that said, with, yep, their workouts, what does that look like? Can you take us through maybe just a little sample of, you know, we're not in a gym, obviously, working on machines and such. I assume, is it more free-weighted exercise, body-weighted exercises probably?
Yeah, free weights, and it really depends on the person. Mm-hmm. You know, I have some clients that just have dumbbells and kettlebells and a mat, uh-huh, stability ball. I have, yeah, some clients that have resistant bands, trampoline, jump rope. So basically, you know, for the clients that are, you know, that we're really customizing stuff for,
yeah,
they're either asking me what do they need, or they're saying, hey, this is what I have. Can we design it around that? And I don't mind going and buying, cool, a couple other things.
Yeah.
So that's basically we're doing that. You know, with our monthly, and we have a monthly membership site where people can go in and pay monthly. Mm-hmm. And they, one of the things that they get is three workouts with me every single week.
Cool.
So I do the workout and they can do the workout right along with me. And it's at any level. So I will slow it down. I'll explain different tiers and say, okay, you know, if you do it this way, if you can't do this way, here's a modification. If you can't do this, then here's another modification. So, mm-hmm, we have people at all skill levels on our membership that, you know, are able to access it whenever. They can do it at their own time. Like you said, if you're at 5 o'clock and you're stuck in traffic, you get there at 5:15, then it throws everything off. You're not there all on time. Now you have access to the workout whenever you want. So mm-hmm. if you decide you want to get up at 4 o'clock in the morning to work out, you can get up at 4 o'clock in the morning and work out. But I've already sent you the workouts. I've sent you the videos, sent you everything. And then we either communicate through text message or we communicate through Voxer or email and are able to communicate with everybody. And it's worked really, really well. You know, you don't have to be hovering over somebody in person to say, hey, you know, you're doing this wrong, or you need to correct this, or you need to correct that. We haven't had anybody, you know, saying, oh, my form is bad or this. I mean, we just, you know, take a picture or a video, boom, send it to them. And everybody's doing great, losing weight, getting in shape, reversing chronic illness, all the same stuff that we had to do in person. We can do it online.
Yeah, that's awesome. That's really cool. These companies, yeah. like you said too, Nathan, like the corporations that are not leasing building space and paying for these expensive, corporate buildings and expenses, do you see that staying the way it is, or do you think that it might just come back to normal? Do you think it might just a little bit come back and stay a little bit this way? And, you know, traffic, what do you see happening here in the next, let's say, rest of this year?
I think people, as humans, I think we need interaction with people. Mm-hmm. So I think a lot of people are going to come back. Mm-hmm. But I also, with all the misinformation out there with COVID, you know, there's been a whole nother level of distrust with the government and distrust with you know, the information that's out there. Like, mm-hmm. you don't know what to trust. So I think a lot of people are going to still be apprehensive and they're going to stay home.
Yeah.
But I think for the most part, because if you go to gyms, I mean, some gyms have this mask mandate where you have to wear a mask everywhere you go. But then I've seen other gyms that are completely open as if nothing is going on.
Right. Exactly.
So, yeah. you know, I think that those kind of, you know, those atmospheres, I think people are going to be jumping right back in. But then I think some people are going to stay home, but I just don't think it's going to be that much. I think that, you know, personally, like I was saying, as humans, we need interaction. We want to see people. We want to be connected, not by video, but by, you know, by being in person with people. So I think it's going to come back. I think it's just going to take some time.
Yeah. Yeah, definitely. Yeah. You know, it's interesting. Last time you and I talked, we really focused a lot of the interview on the whole fear mongering of the media, which I agree, they definitely should be guilty of what they do. And you're right about the whole trust and misinformation. I have to ask this on a personal question because I'm really curious. I'm asking all my guests this. And I'm really curious to see what you and Stephanie, what your direction on it. What do you think of the vaccine? I have to ask, are you going to take the vaccine?
Okay. Yeah. No, not taking the vaccine. Because, you know, I was, so just a little disclaimer at the bottom, I'm in the military, but this is not the stance of the military. I'm not representing the military during this interview.
Sure.
Mm-hmm. Anything that I say has nothing to do with the military whatsoever.
Sure. Sure.
When COVID first happened, I was deployed against COVID, and we were going into senior living facilities and decontaminating. We were doing mobile test sites. We were doing static test sites. And for about 9 weeks, you know, I was in charge of 150 soldiers. Plus, we were also with the National Guard, and I'm in the State Guard. So we were together this whole time. The entire time we were together, all of the missions that we did, all of the operations that we did, not one of my soldiers got COVID. Hmm. We were in hotspots. We were in senior living facilities, and we were in areas like in Albany where it was a hotbed. I mean, people were dying, I mean, just daily, all the time. Mm-hmm. So I have 150 soldiers. We had the National Guard with us. Nobody got COVID. And I just, like, I still haven't to this day. It's been a year. Still haven't gotten COVID. Stephanie hasn't gotten COVID. We interact with people on a regular basis. We still go to family dinner once a month. Mm-hmm. My parents haven't gotten COVID. My brothers haven't gotten COVID. My nieces and nephews haven't gotten COVID. You know, I just can't imagine that 150 soldiers are all asymptomatic and nobody's gotten it. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, you have this vaccine that they're pushing out. Now, just take a step back. I don't get the flu shot. I've only had the flu. I'm 45. I've only had the flu twice in my life. Hmm. And I've never gotten a flu shot, not even when I was younger. So I just, you know, I vaccines are, you know, certain vaccines like chickenpox and measles and that kind of stuff. Okay, sure. But when it comes to this, it's been pushed out so fast.
Mm-hmm.
I don't, you know, you don't know what's going on with it. I know it attaches itself to one of the proteins in your body. What if it finds out later on that we need that protein and now your body can't produce it? So I just, you know, people are like, oh, I'm going to go get the vaccination. I'm like, yeah, but have you had COVID? Well, no. Anybody in your family had COVID? No. You've been around people. You know, you can't go to a gym. You can't go to a small gym, but you can go to Costco, you know, and I don't know. I don't know. There's a lot of fishiness and, you know, does it work? Maybe, maybe not. I don't know. Maybe the ones forcing us to get, you know, get the vaccine, maybe they should vaccinate and make sure that it's not saline water. And then let them go on for a year, 2 years, see what effects they have. And then, you know, maybe I'll get it. But right now, I don't get sick very often. I haven't had any kind of symptoms whatsoever. Steph hasn't had any symptoms.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, we were asked, do you want to get the vaccine as being part of the, you know, the military? And I declined. My entire, as a matter of fact, all the guys that I cover, they all declined. So, and again, that's not a military stance. That's an individual stance. They gave us an option to do that or not do it. And there were some guys that did want to do it. To each his own. If it makes you feel more safe and secure, then, I mean, you know, they said that one mask wasn't enough. You need to wear two or three masks. So what is it? You know what I mean? I mean, the same people that are telling you to wear three masks are the same people that say, hey, let me shoot you in the butt with this. I don't think so. I think I'm going to wait and let's ride this. Let's ride this wave out just a little bit longer before we start sticking needles in.
Yeah, we could do a whole 30 minutes on that whole topic there because you know, I'm with you that it just seems really there's so many what ifs and whys that are really unanswered out there. And it all comes back. I think last time you and I were talking about when you look back at the foundation of this whole thing, almost a lot of things have to do with politics. And unfortunately, I think this might be another, you know, kind of reading between the lines there of where that's headed. But you know, in the fitness center, the gyms, for example, I see a lot of the elderly members who, I guess, they're pretty much not only eligible, but as soon as they are, they get the vaccine. And I'm with you on that too. I'm on the fence, I guess I should say, in terms of, I don't feel comfortable with being vaccinated by something that's been around less than whatever, several months, and hasn't had long research, long-term data available. And so that kind of scares me. It's kind of worrisome. I'll just tell you personally, from my feeling, they use that word herd immunity. And if they say that whatever, 65, I don't know what it is, 70% of the population gets the vaccine, then my question is, well, then does the 30-35% of us who didn't get it, then are we okay? Do we not have to get it then? I mean, because I'd rather, if that was the case, be in that boat. But I just hope it doesn't come down to, you know, you hear these rumors about you, oh, you know, you're going to be forced to get it, or if you don't want to fly on an airplane or what have you, you're going to have to show identity. That's what I'm really fearful of, you know, with our rights being taken away. And I think that's a big part of it.
Yeah, I'm in the same boat as you. I don't like being forced to do anything. I mean, you know, there's certain things that we have to do, right?
Yeah.
I mean, as a society, we have to pay some taxes because we drive on roads and we have access to things that we wouldn't have. So, you know, paying some taxes, okay, great.
Right.
But when it comes to, you know, when we have a constitution, you know, this country was built. I mean, my parents and I'm a third generation American. My great grandparents fled Germany. So we know about socialism. We know about fascism. We know about national, you know, crazy people.
Yeah.
And when you start forcing people, when you start taking away things from people and saying you have to do this and you can't do this. And then it's like, you know what? Why did we leave Europe? You know? So,
yeah,
I'm right there with you. You know, you keep saying that they're going to have this certificate that you can print out that's going to say you were vaccinated and you're going to have to show this. It's going to be like your papers to go anywhere. You know, that's another reason I kind of like our businesses online. You know,
you can use
Instacart, not go anywhere. You know, flying. I don't know. Maybe we'll be to the point where we're making enough money that we can have private jets and we don't have to worry about flying with you know, people anymore. Yeah. So, I mean, it's crazy. It's just crazy.
Yeah. Yeah. That's a good word. I mean, sure. You know, the other benefit of how you're working is you don't need to wear a mask too. I mean, that's awesome to not be able to, you know, personally, that's one of the biggest things I'm hoping that they get rid of. I mean, they're told wear a two mask now. I mean, come on, that's just a little, I think that is extreme. But I think you're right. You know, there's a bigger picture here that I keep thinking about is like, it's a slippery slope is what I'm worried that once, okay, we're going to all take the vaccine, then they're going to come out and say, oh, by the way, we're going to need everyone's social security number and we're going to need you to tattoo that on your wrist so that way it's easier. You know, it works. That's the thing that I'm worried that when's this thing going to stop and is this just the beginning of something bigger? And I don't know. I don't like to be paranoid, and maybe I'm just being kind of conspiracy theorist, but in some ways, I don't know. It's definitely a lot that we don't know. There's a lot of uncertainty out there.
Yeah, and you know, it's different. Like when I think the trust in the government started to decline during the Vietnam War because they were lying a lot.
Yes.
You know, up until that point, the trust in the government was really, really high. You know, they said they did what they said for the most part. But when it came out with the Vietnam War and everything was just they were lying and there was twisting and turning truths and not giving half truths and just completely under the table stuff. Then that's when it started to decline. And now it's like, who do you trust?
Yeah.
And honestly, you know, I don't think you can. There are people in both parties that are just really untrustworthy, and they're all about power.
Sure.
And when you get those kind of people in those offices where they're dictating policy, then it's like for the rest of us, it's like, oh my gosh, you know. And they sound great, right? They're very good orators and they're very charismatic. But when they get in there and they start changing stuff, they're like, whoa, wait a minute now, hold on a second. And that's like you said, you know, if you watch 1984 or read the book 1984. Or if you watched anything like Atlas Shrugged or something like that, then you start looking. And you're like, I don't know. Am I a conspiracy theorist, or is this actually really happening? Is it as bad as I think it is? Or, man, it's really changed. But I mean, just you know, from the time we're getting older now. From the time that we've grown up, things have changed. You know, and it just seems like a lot more liberties and a lot more things are you know, being taken away slowly. And over time, I remember in college being in a sociology class and how it talked about you go from different cycles of different types of societies. And, you know, democracies and republics always start to turn into socialism, which also turn into communism. And then it goes all the way back through. But I mean, if you haven't learned anything, if you don't read and learn and study history, you keep going back and you keep making the same errors that history they just keep repeating itself over and over and over again. I'm like, you think it's going to – so you're telling me that you think that out of all these failed tries at socialism and communism, you think now this time it's going to work. It's never worked, you know. You don't – and I said this to somebody the other day because they were like, well, you know, socialism. I'm like, people are on boats and rafts coming to the United States. They're not going to Venezuela. You know, they're not going to socialist countries. They're not going to Cuba, right?
Yeah, right.
They're passing Cuba, coming all the way up here. You know, when you want asylum, you go to the next country over. They're going to eight different countries to come all the way up here. So obviously we have an ideology that is something that's so beautiful that people from other countries want. And that's why like we have to celebrate that.
Yeah.
What is it? Yeah. Why are people coming here and not going anywhere else? You know, and that's the thing, like that's it. It's an ideology that people believe that you can have this American dream. You can be, do and have whatever you want. You don't have to hurt anyone else. Yeah, sure. There's people out there that hurt people. You're not going to change that. You're not going to change that with laws. It's just human nature.
Yeah.
But, you know, but people want to, you know, come here as an immigrant legally. And come here and they want to get a job and they want to do something and they want to better their family. They want to better themselves. And you see people, you know, that start with a convenience store one day and are multimillionaires with multiple convenience stores. And that's just one thing because I was reading about that. But they have multiple locations or multiple dry cleaners or they start their own corporation, whatever it is. But within a couple of generations, it doesn't take long lifetimes and lifetime and lifetime and hundreds of years. You know, you come, you have that work. That's the work ethic. I think a lot of Americans that are here are just fat and lazy and big crybabies. and they don't want to work for it. You know, and that's the sad part. The American dream is out there. If you want to work for it, you want to go get it, you can do anything that you want. This is the only country in the world that you can do that. Mm-hmm. You know, and that's what's so exciting to me. And that's what I'm afraid of is like, oh, no, you're going to be a bread maker and you guys are only allowed this amount of bread. You're going to go pave streets. You're going to go pick up trash. I mean, we're going to start, you know, assigning stuff. If you really want to get, you know, crazy about it, it's like, you don't do what you want to do. You're going to get done with what somebody's going to point you. This is what you are going to do. This is what you are going to do. But I want to do. No, you can't do that. It's not the way this works. Mm-hmm. You have two cars. You only need one car. You have five people in your family. You only need one car. You know, oh, you have a 5-bedroom house. Yeah. 2-bedroom house looks good for you. You know, I mean, that's the slippery slope. Mm-hmm. You know, how far it can. People are like, oh, no, it can't go that far. It has in the past.
Right.
Mm-hmm. So don't, you know, it has several times in the past. Mm-hmm. So when people say, oh, it's not going to be that way. Well, it kind of looks like it's going that direction, you know?
Yeah.
So I'm right there with you. I am right there with you. So.
Yeah. It's so interesting, Nathan, you know, and again, I agree. We do live in the freest country in the world, and we have every opportunity to help ourselves and make ourselves the best that we can be. And again, this ties back to what you and I try to provide is a healthier lifestyle and improvement to people's well-being. And you and Stephanie are two of the best that do that. And so I commend you again for being so awesome. And again, I love how you're able to provide this now with this, like you said, it wasn't available when you and I were starting into this business, but now here we are able to train people online and take them grocery shopping and educate them and teach them properly and motivate them. With all of that said, that's just wonderful. So that's terrific. I want to ask you, Nathan, as we're getting towards the end here, just a few more questions too.
Yeah.
Let's go ahead and take this time to talk about again, anybody listening or watching, they're like, you know what, I want to try Trinity. I want to try Nathan and Stephanie out. What's the best ways that they can reach you, and what do you recommend to them in terms of getting started, and how can they best get in touch with you?
Okay, one of the easiest ways, if you just want to check out our programs, you can go to 21daybodytransformationchallenge.com. That's going to be our 21-day program. And then if you want to check out our memberships site, you can go to trinitybody.com and check that out. One of the best ways, if you don't know who we are and you're like, I'm not ready to buy from you yet, no problem. What I would do is go to Facebook, find me on Facebook, or go to Trinity Fitness, look for the logo. We have a public page, and then we have a private group page. And go in. Go in and ask to be accepted into the private group. You have to answer 3 questions, but it's free. But we do go in there because we create so much value, and we have such a good environment in there that it is a private group. We don't just let anybody come in, but you're going to get served so well there. Every Friday, 09 at 9 o'clock in the morning, I do a live workout with you guys. So you have access to that. And then we're just constantly just so much information on fitness, nutrition, empowerment. We have a life coach in there that helps with her programs and teaches people life coaching, you know, how to work out if you're a single mom with 2 toddlers. I mean, all sorts of stuff. So that's there. But if you look at the logo, you'll see this logo. You'll see the N. And that's where you can go. So if you're just brand new, check out our Facebook group. Jump in. You can be anybody. Just introduce yourself. Boom, you're good to go. But if you are looking at, you know, say, hey, you know what? I want to check out a program, 21daybodytransformationchallenge.com or trinitybody.com.
Perfect. Good, Nathan. Well, let me ask you one more question before we let you get out of here. What would you recommend for people watching right now, listening, and they're kind of just feeling discouraged, and they've got the COVID blues and all that, and they're just trying to figure out where to, you know, they want to go ahead and check your website out. But what suggestions and help could you give to them for just kind of turning their spirits around and hopefully seeing that, you know, less doom and gloom and more positivity is in store for them as we're hopefully nearing the end of the pandemic? What could you tell them?
Absolutely. First of all, get outside, because and turn off social media if you're if you're there watching news, or just turn off regular primetime news. You don't need to be so inundated all the time with the garbage that's out there. And understand that the person living, on both sides of you. I mean, we're all in this together. Okay. We're all experiencing this together. So you can lock arms with people. I know that unless you're on an island somewhere, which is probably the best place to be right now, unless you're not, you have friends that are probably experiencing maybe some of the same things you are, or get into a group on social media where you can interact with people that are going to lift you up. And all you need is that gentle nudge, right? You're not alone. You're not by yourself. Mm-hmm. We're here. Other people are here to help you. Taryn's here to help you. And that thing, people think, oh, well, you're just a personal trainer. No, we're way more. Taryn and I are way more than that. There are a lot of just trainers out there. But when it comes to Taryn, when it comes to myself, we're here. We're using fitness and nutrition and healthy lifestyle as a way to empower people mm-hmm. to live what I call a peak performance life. Mm-hmm. And when you start to eat a little better, right, you start to move a little bit more, you're mm-hmm. going to get those endorphins. You're going to get that kind of runner's high. You're going to start to feel better, and then you're going to want to do more. So that's my thing is start moving. And even if it's, I don't want to run. Just go walk. Well, I don't want to walk too far. Okay, well, then just walk down to the mailbox and back, or down mm-hmm. to the end of the street and back. It doesn't have to be that far. Mm-hmm. Start slow. Mm-hmm. Start small. But just do something. Just start. I can't eat. You're eating pizza 3 times a day. All right, stop eating pizza. Eat it twice a day, right? But in the morning, have something else to eat. Just start small. If you want to see results, tomorrow, right, or next week, then you're going to obviously have to do big changes. But if you're just starting small, you need a gentle nudge to kind of push you out the door, then just walk to the end of the street and back. You see somebody out there like we saw the other day, one of our neighbors was like, oh, you guys are walking all the time. Yeah, because we work at home and we need to feel good. We need to get outside. We need some fresh air. We need mm-hmm. to feel things that are going on. And you're going to start to notice that the doom and gloom that you see in front of your screen is not what's out there. There are some happy, shiny people out there, and you need to get back involved with them. Even if you're going to wear 3 masks, just get out there and you'll start to see more happy people, and you'll start to feel better about yourself. It's not that hard. I know it's like when we're sitting in that dump, we're like, oh, man, everything's so bad. But if you just stop for a minute and go, is it really? Is it really that bad? What is so bad? And then you start to question all the thoughts that come into your head. You're like, oh, wait a minute. I've been playing the wrong song. I've been playing the wrong channel. Let me get up and change the channel because this rerun, I don't like this rerun. So rather than just allowing the TV to play, you get up and change the channel, or you change the channel on the remote. Change the channel of your life. That's all you got to do. And then get out there and start meeting some people, talking to people, get in some good Facebook groups, get into some like-minded people that are trying to live better and be better and have more and do more. And that's the thing. And be grateful. Be grateful for today. Because we don't know what tomorrow is going to lead. Be grateful that you can breathe, that you can see, that you can feel things. I mean, you can get down to the very essence of the smallest pieces of being grateful, the things that we take for granted every single day. The fact that I can see you on a screen. 20 years ago, 30 years ago, could we see each other on a screen? No. We couldn't communicate like this at all. We would be recluses in our houses in a pandemic. But we can actually talk. We can actually communicate. We can give and deliver value to people all over the world just by watching this. Mm-hmm. And that right there, it's freaking fantastic because there's so much that we can do to help other people. So sometimes if you're feeling a little down, go out and help somebody else, because in that help of helping somebody else, you're going to feel that gratitude. You're going to feel that giving, and that's going to help open up your heart, and you're going to start to feel good. And again, get that dopamine and that epinephrine rush, and you'll feel much better. So start with that first.
Very well said, Nathan. That's awesome. Thank you so much again. Great way to cap it off there, and a wonderful summary. And I really appreciate your time, Nathan. As always, 30 minutes with you just flies by like it's 2 minutes and like nothing.
It really does. Every time.
So, yeah, it does. So thank you again. Please tell Stephanie we said hello. Y'all take care. I look forward to seeing both of you soon. Hopefully in the future in person, we need to get out there and meet up again. And as we fade to black, absolutely. Nathan, I'll say goodbye now and wish you a wonderful rest of the day. Again, great job, wonderful video blog. And here comes your information on the screen as we fade to black.